L'idea di questa esposizione è nata proprio in coincidenza con Expo, perché abbiamo pensato che un tema così importante come quello di Feed the Planet ovviamente non poteva prescindere dall'argomento acqua. L'obiettivo di questa mostra è sensibilizzare l'opinione pubblica attraverso la cultura, la bellezza e l'arte. Questo fondamentalmente è quello che Burtynsky fa da sempre. Edward Burtynsky ha questa capacità di portare il sublime in paesaggi meravigliosi, li trasforma in fotografie emblematiche e quindi la sua particolarità è innanzitutto uno stile che ha sempre utilizzato il grande formato, una definizione delle immagini impressionante che ovviamente ti racconta tutto quello che c'è intorno in quel paesaggio. Attraverso la fotografia spiega, racconta, sensibilizza. Da sempre Edward Burtynsky ogni progetto che affronta ha dietro una ricerca impressionante sia da un punto di vista scientifico che da un punto di vista visuale. Quindi quando si è trattato di affrontare un tema così esteso come quello dell'acqua ha pensato bene di dividerlo in capitoli. Quindi ha iniziato ad affrontare quello che sono le devastazioni, in primis il Golfo del Messico, quello che è successo con il disastro ecologico. Poi è passato a studiare e fotografare l'agricoltura, l'acquacoltura, quindi tutta una serie di analisi di quello che è l'utilizzo dell'acqua, fino ad arrivare all'origine dell'acqua, perché l'ultimo capitolo parla proprio delle sorgenti, le sorgenti indispensabili di questo elemento fondamentale per la nostra vita.
The exhibition Aqua Shock is to bring the viewer into this world that we all inhabit every day, water, but to make us think about water in a different way, as a precious resource. Something that if we don't treat properly can come back and it harm us. So in a way this is an exploration of our relationship to water and how important it is to maintain a healthy relationship with water, as without it no water equals no life. The water project started, I think, only as a result of doing some earlier work. I did a project on oil, and I spent 12 years looking and photographing the effect of oil and our relationship to oil. So to me, these two things were complementary and important to our daily existence. So I was trying to find, as an artist, a way to bring these ideas into a visual form and make them present in our consciousness, so we begin to think deeper about these types of relationships. The technology has had a large impact on how I can work today as versus how I could work 10 years ago. In the water project, if you go through the show, you might notice that I'm always in an elevated point of view. So I'm either in a helicopter or I'm in a plane, and even in some cases I'm using a drone, so I'm using a remote to be able to capture that. So I used a bit of everything in this project, because to actually define water, I found that you had to actually get high. But because of the challenges of doing the water project, I had a lot of filmmakers when I was working and making the film as well, were still capturing moments of me at work. So the Where I Stand became an interesting idea, in that there were so many different techniques used to make this exhibition of getting up in the air, that I thought for the viewer of the show, it would be interesting to see behind the scenes some of the tools that I was using. And so that Where I Stand, it tells a bit of the story about the different ways in which I approached picture making in this process. I haven't had as much trouble in doing the water project. I think most people involved in the industry of using water or distributing water are not necessarily threatened by the camera. I had greater problems on the oil project, getting into refineries or getting into sensitive oil fields in places like Saudi Arabia, I could never even get in. So with the water project, it wasn't so much denying access. I'm beginning to look, because I've done so much work in China, I've also been looking at how China is expanding and how globalization is now moving beyond the borders of China, and China's relationship in particularly with Africa. And I'm looking at Africa as well. And I'm also looking at another movie, maybe doing a survey of all the different themes that I've looked at over 30 years and trying to encompass them into a movie, including mining and quarrying and deforestation and other aspects of human relationship to the landscape.